Hello and welcome to my e-lesson. I am your guru, and in this video I'll tell you how you can prepare a full-fledged salary slip in Excel and print it also and give it to your employees. Alright, it has all the possible headers that can be there, and the calculations are also done. Alright, you can simply just go to my website myelesson.org and download it from there with the template, so that all the formulas etc. are built in. And once the salary sheet is created, you will be able to print it also. Let me show you how. I'll click on File. Alright, I'll click on Print. And you'll be able to print it. Even you'll be able to export it as PDF. So I'll click on Create PDF. I'll give it a name. Save it on the desktop. Alright. Ensure that save as type is PDF. And I'll click on Publish. Now I'll be using Wondershare PDF Element 6 as the PDF tool. Why? Because it is super safe and extremely fast also. It allows you to edit anything that you want. You can choose conversion options also. You can convert it to Word, Excel, PPT, and comment in the PDF super easily. All right, this is amazing. So I use PDF Element 6 whenever I want to convert my files to PDF. Now coming back to the slip, I'll show you how I have gone ahead and made it. So over here, what I have done is that I have made this slip wherein the company name is mentioned over here. This is the salary slip for the month of March. And then you can mention the employee name, employee number, that is his ID, designation and department over here. And here are the salary details, which I have broken in two parts, additions and deductions. So these are the salary heads, the basic salary. Say, for example, this is 25,000. And then here are the allowances. So house rent allowance, conveyance allowance, transport allowance, CEA, special allowance, and others. All these can be mentioned over here. All right. And then I have mentioned total allowance over here, wherein the total of this cell B13 till B18 is done. So I've used the sum formula. Very simple. I've added this much. All right. And now, say, example, house rent allowance, I give 2000. So over here, see, gross salary is 27,000. Why? Basic salary plus the allowances. So I have done a formula wherein sum is equal to this cell plus this cell. And then here are your employer contributions, the PF from employer. All right. This is your basic salary into 13.6%, or whatever percentage would be there in your system. Usually this is 13.6. All right. And ESI employment and the ESI contributor, which is 4.75% if your salary is less than 15%. That is the basic salary. If it is greater than 15%, then nothing. So I have used the if formula over here. If you see, you can see it over here. If B11, that is this one, is less than or equal to 15,000, then 4.75% of B11, else zero. All right. So in this case, it is 25,000. So it is zero ESI contribution. But if it is, say, 14,000, let me type 14,000 over here. See, ESI contribution also comes in. So we can keep with ESI contribution if you want. But usually, all right. And then here are the reimbursements, which you can mention over here. And then the total reimbursements are summed up over here. All right. And then this is your CTC, 18,569, which is a sum of these cells. All right. From here till here. So that's your total CTC. Simple, correct? And this is the annual. I simply multiplied this with the month in a year. That is, I simply multiplied this with the months in a year. That is 12. Over here, I mentioned the deductions. The PF from the employee side, which is the gross salary, which is the basic salary, into 11.12%, and the ESI contribution from the employee, again, if it is less than 15,000, then the employee contribution would be 1.75%. If it is greater than 15,000, the basic, then the zero, then there will be zero contribution from employee and employer. I have done the totaling of this sales over here. All right. And then here's a summary. That's the gross salary. All right. Which is over here. In case in the summary, you want to mention the total reimbursed allowances, you can mention them over here. These are the reimbursed sections, deductions, TDS, FBT, loan EMIs, whatever can be mentioned over here. And the next salary can be mentioned over here. And once this is done, all right, you can print it very easily. You go to file, you go to print, and you can print it very easily. Super easy. And in case you want to create a PDF of it, you click on export, you click on create PDF, and it will be created. Now I have gone ahead and downloaded a great PDF creator software called PDFelement 6, which allows you to create PDFs and also allows you to edit them and annotate them. A lot of features are there, and it can be downloaded from this website. The link is mentioned in the description, and you can download the free version from here super easily. It is an amazing tool. Let me show you how it works. So I click on create PDF, and it will ask me for a name. All right, I'll give it a name, save it on the desktop, click publish. See, once it is created, you can even, if required, edit it from here. There are a lot of features which you can use. All right. There are, in PDFelement, if you go, you will be able, PDFelement also provides you hundreds of templates which you can use very, very easily. So do try it out. So this is how we create a salary slip in Excel. Do not forget to go to myelesson.org to download this template. All right, all the calculations are done. You simply have to create it and send it to your employees. All right. Well, I hope you liked this video. If you did, please do click on the thumbs up symbol and do subscribe to the channel so that whenever there's a new video that I create, you will be notified about it. Well, then, until the next video, this is your guru now signing off for the day. Have a wonderful day ahead. Happy learning.